My name is Calvin Mackay. I'm 24, two-time intermediate champion at 64 kilograms, light welterweight.
Right, and what condition would you say you're in just now?
The best.
Is that right? Every boxer says that. What do you love about the sport of boxing?
I don't know, just the passion, just the fitness, everything about it.
And how hard do you, when you push yourself to train, how hard do you train yourself? Do you go above and beyond?
Yeah, definitely. Well, recently for the Open Championships I'm training for just now, that's like Commonwealth level sort of type of people. So just as much as I can, running in the morning and then even at night after training.
And when it comes to like boxing and stuff like that, do you ever have your own like entrance sort of music, or is there a tune that you'd like to have?
Yeah, well, not really for the championships, but home shows and that.
Right.
Oasis, Cigarettes and Alcohol.
And what does that say about you, that song? How does it relate to you?
The way I come, just the way it, like, it makes me feel, the way I come in, just, I don't know, the passion and everything like that.
Right, and out of all the punches that you do, what's your favourite? What's your one that you try and land?
Probably a left to the body, try and take people out from the body, kidney punch.
Is that right?
Yeah, you want to try it? You
just do a soft one. Oh, jeez! I'm winded, hold on. No, I'm alright,
So, you recently, at one of the home shows, knocked somebody out.
It was my first fight. I was training for 6 months. Got my first fight in the home show. Prediction knockout.
Is that right?
It came true.
What round?
It was the second round, one minute into it.
Don't knock me out.
Yep.
But we're at roughly that minute point of that second round. Just slowly do what you did in sort of slow motion.
Yeah, stepped in. Right hook,
oof.
No, but then you stumbled, overhand right, night.
And that was it? Night sweep.
That was it, yeah.
Right, have you got an idea of like entrance music for home shows? What
was it? It was DMX, gonna give it to you.
Okay. Why did you pick that?
Oh, I was listening to songs, and I thought that'd be the best one, because next year I did give it to him, so.
Right in the face. And when it comes to training, how far do you push yourself? Do you go up and beyond?
As hard as I can, as hard as I can go, because injuries. It's what friends these back, I elbow a bit cards up and go push myself every night.
Fuck it, come on. No, didn't want you to do that! Right, ding, that's it.
In 5-6 nights a week, I'd say, and two hours a night with runs in the morning is going to give you the best chance of winning.
Right, okay. And when it comes to looking at the sport, looking at both ends of the spectrum, is there anything easy about it?
It's quick. It's easy.
Anything easy, anything difficult?
No, there's nothing easy about a sport. It's hard work. Every day you get up. Getting up in the morning before work for runs, your dieting's hard, fighting's hard, losing's hard, winning's even harder, you know.
And looking at you're in great shape and you're fast. Let me tell you, it's obvious that you've got the experience here.
Yeah.
Mentally, what's it like being a boxer?
Well, I struggle mentally sometimes. Putting there against yourself another man in 50-50 fights, it's nerve-wracking. Anyone who doesn't get nervous is lying, I think.
But that would help, though, I think, the nerves.
You know, but you know, once the bell rings, you go in and you throw that first combination, the nerves are gone. Then the training comes into play after that.
Right. That's what keeps you sort of going, sort of thing.
Aye.
Go give me a wee combination. Don't hit me too hard. I didn't even saw the second. hold on. I didn't even saw the second one. I was like, that's our jab. What was that second one? Was that a hook?
A left hook. Sit down side.
A left hook. I'm like Rocky. I've got a bad right side. That's what it is.
I'm Lauren Mackay, 37, current Scottish Novice Champion, 3-0.
How long have you held the title there, the Scottish Novice Champion? How long
just
this
year. This year I got it, so hopefully next year I'll keep it undefeated.
And how much work went into building up to that?
Training camp was about 3 to 4 months long.
Oof. Right, okay. And what was the fight like itself? Where you won?
Fight was good. Yeah, it was a difficult fight. I fought the girl before, but I won it, so got the result.
Won before?
Yeah, but I boxed that girl before, and I'd beat her unanimous before. So.
Right. Okay.
Yeah, delighted. So yeah.
That would help going back into it, I think, beating someone before then.
Yeah, good points and bad points. Good points is that it'd been about a year, so I'd improved, but I also had in my head that she improved as well. So,
right, okay. So
yeah, it wasn't an easy fight, but it was good and I won it.
And what made you get into boxing?
About 6 years ago, I had my first child.
Right.
We Hamish, and about a year after that, I contacted Liam, asked if I could come to just workout classes.
Yeah.
And from the workout classes, he invited me into sparring classes, and then from sparring classes, I was competing.
Is that right?
Yeah.
That's amazing. So you first of all got in and thought, right, I'm going to get fit this year, because boxing is brilliant for fitness.
Yeah.
I mean, you can't beat it, can you?
Oh, it's all about the fitness, yeah. And I just got into it that way. I had no big intentions about sparring, to be honest. But
that's amazing.
But yeah, I loved it once I got in the ring.
Yeah, once you get a decent level of fitness, you could start doing a bit of sparring, which is just like getting ready, obviously practicing, getting in the ring, doing a bit of boxing. Once you do that for a while, you can start doing, you can get registered and start doing boxing for competitions.
Now, you had a semi-final one a couple of weekends ago. This weekend, you've got a title fight this weekend?
Yeah, it's the final Saturday, right, in the Ashgill Centre down in Glasgow.
Okay, and mentally, how do you feel about that? How you feel? Because you're obviously in great nick.
Yeah, I'm in good shape just now. Mentally, I know I can beat the boy. He's tailor-made for me. He's quite a tall boy. I like my favourite shots, probably the overhand right. It'll be perfect to land in his face.
Do you want to just do one now? And I'll just,
yeah,
but not
totally.
Too hard though, eh? Like,
sure.
Do you know what I mean? Picture you're hitting like a wee chihuahua or something, yeah, like okay. That, right? You don't want to hurt it. Oh, jeez, right, okay. So how much more? But give me a wee bit stronger than that. Not, don't full force, yeah. But a wee bit. Oh, Jesus. Hold on, can I get my cup, man?
Thank you for having me down.
No problem.
And thank you for punishing me in the ring with some of your amazing boxers. It's been a great season for you guys. You are breaking records and we're not even midway through.
That's correct, yeah. It's great. The 2015-2016 class are breaking records. We've taken more gold medals and titles back to Inverness than any club before it at any time in history. So, yeah, it's a great time for the club just now, yeah.
And you've got some great boxers. I've had first-hand experience, yeah, of that. There's a semi-final coming up. Who's fighting that?
The semi-final's been, we've got our final coming up this weekend for Andrew Coogan. Maybe see him in the background working away there. So he's fighting for the lightweight title, and he's already been part of the success this season. He won the lightweight title earlier on this year, and this intermediate title is in addition to this, so it's the next step up for him competitively, so it'd be great if he could bring that back to Inverness for us.
And amazing that he's just been at it for it's a couple of years, he was saying.
And credit to Andrew, because Andrew's probably, you know, from someone coming in the door for the first time, you know, just as a general person coming along for fitness, Andrew's had one of the most rapid transitions from just a general guy working out to where he is now. But I can't take all the credit for that. That's Andrew as an individual as well, because he's pushed himself and had the hunger and determination to get himself there. But yeah, a real rapid transition that he's made from just a normal regular guy to a Scottish boxing champion.
And for the area, boxing is it's very popular, and these, yeah, guys are really putting this academy on the map.
Yeah.
You've got home shows. What's good about the home shows if you wanted to attend?
Well, for us personally, speaking for our club, a home show is great because of the success that we bring to Inverness as our club. It's great to take that back and give the boxing fans of Inverness, you know, a chance to capture that, because they don't always get a chance to see these guys travel, you know, and win tournaments at different places. So when we bring it back, it's really like the homecoming, us bringing back our champions and the success that we've had on the road, and bringing it back and letting the people of Inverness and the boxing fans of Inverness get an opportunity to catch that in their city.